हेलो फ्रेंड्स, लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ। आई एम उर्वी पंचोली। आई एम एम कॉम बी एड, ऑल्सो आई हैव डन इंटर सी ए। लेट अस स्टडी द सब्जेक्ट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड मैनेजमेंट टुगेदर। इन फर्स्ट स्टैंडर्ड 12th इन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड मैनेजमेंट वी हैव 12 चैप्टर्स एंड we will be studying the first chapter today, nature and significance of management. Let us start the chapter with introduction. So let me introduce how management came into existence. Students, management was already into existence even during the stone age period. We can see management in animals. We can see management during the historical period. You can say during the time of Shivaji, or take the example of management during pre-independence period, or you can say management existed long ago. Correct? Okay. Let me give you the example of animals. Yeah. Okay. Have you ever looked into the sky when the birds fly? You will see a proper pattern that they form and they fly together. Why do they do so? Because that is management. That is management. Yeah. Okay. Another example of management, you will see in ants. You all must have seen an ant hole. Yeah. And what is inside the ant hole? Entire ant family lives together. Correct? So some of the members, that is some of the ants, will collect the food. Some will store them. Everyone will be having a different duty to do. There will be a queen ant that is observed in ants. Correct? Why is it so? That is management. That is management. Let us take the example of our house. Correct? There will be some kind of distribution of duties between mother and father. You must all be knowing that. Correct? Mother will be preparing food. Father will be given the job of helping children with studies. Yeah, that can be done by the father. Correct? It may vary according to the family, but you will always observe that there will be distribution of jobs given to one another. Correct? In your family, your mother will give you some kind of jobs that you have to do this, that you have to, at home also, that cleaning the house or anything else. Correct? So what is that? That is management. That is managing the duties. Students, whenever we talk about success, it has to be achieved by management. Yeah, it has to be achieved by management. Correct? Whenever there is no kind of management, one cannot be successful, I can say. Successful in completing the task in time and also with optimum efficiency. Correct? Yeah. So management has to be there. There should be some kind of management. Okay. Let us take the example of our school. Yeah. So first of all, school has been built up and there are employees in the school. The employees are teaching and non-teaching staff. Correct? In the teaching staff, we have principal, we have teachers, and the non-teaching staff, we have the clerk, accountants, all the accountants and all who are doing the administrative work of the school. correct? Also in the non-teaching staff, we have the cleaning workers and peons and all, correct? Yeah. So now, there is distribution of work between the teaching and the non-teaching staff, correct? That is done by the management. Management has given work to the teachers, correct? To the principal, correct? And also to the peon and the cleaning staff, also to the administrative staff in our school. Yeah, okay. There is some kind of planning. Yeah, before having a teacher, recruiting a teacher, there was some kind of planning that this teacher will be teaching maths and science, this teacher will be teaching accounts, BA, this teacher will be teaching history, geography, correct? Yeah, there was some kind of planning. There is also supervision. Yeah, in some schools we have supervisors and but we have the principal. If we don't have the supervisor, we always have the principal, and one of the job of the principal is to supervise the staff. Yes, there will be some kind of coordination. The management will pass some kind of rules and all, and that will be passed on to the teachers. Yes, there will be some kind of guidelines given by the principal and supervisor to the teachers. Yeah, this is coordination, correct? And everyone will work in coordination with each other. There will be guidance from the principal side, supervisor side to the teachers. Yes, and also from the management side to the principal. Yeah, okay. So this is management. This is management. Yeah, we saw planning, supervision, coordination, guidance, correct? Yeah, so this is management. This is management. Managing all the things, correct? So during ancient times, during the era of Stone Age man, human beings, we all know, used to hunt for food. Yeah, there was nothing like going to the school or going for a job and earning and all. So we all used to struggle for the food. Right now the animals do that. Yeah. So, but in that thing also, there was planning, supervision, there was coordination, there was guidance. Yeah, yeah, this all things existed. There was some kind of weapons made for hunting. They used to hunt by making strategies so that they can get the prey as early as possible. Yeah, and then the human being realized his limitations, that a single man cannot do all the job. Yes, all the things cannot be done by the single man. That's why they form groups, and then they managed the entire group. Yeah, for that they received cooperation from others. When there were more than one person, they were able to do the work more early and more efficiently, and also in a systematic manner, correct? But when there are more persons involved, it requires more planning, delegation of authority and responsibility. And whenever there is a requirement of someone, there should be a leader to give some kind of direction, correct? Yeah, so this, all the functions are known as management. All the functions are known as management. Okay. Yeah. In the 11th standard, we have already studied what is sole proprietorship, what is partnership, what is company. Yeah. So in business also, whether it is a sole proprietorship business or it is a partnership or it is a company, it has to be managed. It has to be managed. In sole proprietorship, there is only one owner. He has to manage everything. In partnership, there are more than one owners, correct? Yeah, and they have to manage the firm. In company, we have a management which manages the firm. Company is owned by sole proprietors. We all have studied this earlier. So ये अ वेरी बिग अमाउंट ऑफ कैपिटल इज इन्वॉल्व इन द कंपनी एंड वी रिक्वायर द सर्विस ऑफ एक्सपर्ट्स इन द कंपनी करेक्ट या फॉर द बिजनेस टू एक्सपांड why it is necessary to have a good management because or else the big amount of capital will get wasted, it will turn into losses, yeah, and all our expert team will be sitting idle or will not be giving the required input, yeah. So in business also, whether it is sole proprietorship firm, whether it is partnership firm, or it is company, management is very necessary. All the functions of management, planning, organizing, staffing, directing, controlling, all the functions of management are to be done appropriately for getting the required output from our employees and also for optimum utilization of the resources. So moving on to the next slide, we will study what is management. We will study the meaning of management. Man is a social animal. He lives in groups. We all know that. We have studied from the lower classes that we are social animal. We cannot live alone. We require other people. We live in a family. Yes. He receives cooperation from others to achieve its objectives. To know the concept of management, it is very necessary to understand the meaning of management. Many writers have explained the meaning of management from different viewpoints. Now we will understand the viewpoints of the writers and also the definition of management. So, an expert has said about management. Management is the art of getting things done through others. Let me once again take the example of our school. Yes, our principal and our teachers. Yes. So what sort of management is required in the school? Getting things done through others. In school, you have to get things done through the teachers, correct? All the teachers should give good lectures. All the students should be able to understand the lecture. Yeah? Okay.